Welcome back to the channel. When last we were down here, I was finishing the stub outs for the water. I installed the controller for the floor heat. We got this in on install, got the corner in, got the stub out there for the toilet and the vanity. And today we're going to be working on installing the toilet. I've also put another coat of paint on the floor, and I've got a little bit more paint, but you want to know what? It's time to move on. I've been running the heat for the past week and a half trying to cure the floor, because if it's really tender, it'll scrape up, and I want to avoid that. The longer it's down, the harder it will get, the safer it'll be for scrapes and stuff like that. And even if it does scrape, I've got some touch-up paint. But I don't want to do that. So I'm going to be careful. We're installing the toilet today. What I'm going to do is, I've got the toilet sitting here. It's been out here for quite some time, and the box has disintegrated. It's been out all summer. So I'm going to take this apart, break down the box, take the box inside so I can set the different parts on the box, and then we'll do the installation. Outside so long, we've got a slug out inside the box. There's basically the toilet right there. All right, I just inserted the floor flange. Is a friction fit. Toilet in place, just to get an idea how it would feel, you know, what it would look like. I guess I measured okay 17 years ago. I didn't know what I was doing, but there we have it. So now I just have to put a wax ring on, reset it. This actually is a high profile seat. It seems to be the thing to use for Americans. I went camping and was doing the trowel and cat hole and that whole business, and you want to know what? I thought I'd be like, ew, I don't want to, you know, I thought I'd be squeamish about going outside, but I really wasn't. I'm surprised at how easily and how adaptable I am. We've got the toilet on. I'm gonna put the top on now. Basically, all I did was just pick up the reservoir, then set it down there. There's screws that go on. Here's the nut, and here's the washer. I finished the install, and I thought the camera was filming, and it wasn't. So I'm gonna go to the store today. I'm gonna pick up the supply line. It goes from the wall up to that little black pipe on the bottom of the tank. As all these projects tend to do, I spent a whole day trying to find that supply line for the toilet. I went to the local hardware store twice, got one too small, got one too big. Then I went to the next town over and I had to buy that one. I finally got the right one. I honed in on it, but the toilet's fully functional and operational. The next thing I am doing, this one right here. In this situation, there's going to be one cubby, two cubby, three cubby shelf, one cubby, two cubby, three cubby shelf, and then there'll be a bigger space up above, and I may install a shelf up there to divide that. And that's what I'm going to do right now, cut the material for this build. One thing I did want to mention is my sister's visiting right now, and it's slowing me down. You know, you have people visiting, you want to do stuff with them. You know, I've been cooking and we've been doing family things, just hanging out. I don't get to hang out. I'm always by myself. And this way I got something, when I have somebody here with me, and I'm taking advantage of it. I'm alone all the time, and I don't mind being alone all the time. I'm really okay by myself. You know, there's a difference between being alone and lonely. And sometimes I get lonely. and sometimes I don't want to be alone, and they are two different things, but I'm okay being alone. But sometimes, you know, break it up, shake things up. All right, let's, so this is the material I'm going to be using, MDF. I have some pieces over here. This place is still a mess, but I've actually been cleaning. Things have been disappearing. I have these three pieces and that piece there. And that's what I'm going to use to construct this cubby section. 39 and 9 sixteenths. 9 sixteenths. We've transferred down to the apartment. I have got all the cuts done. Gosh, can you even see all that dirt? You know, I was near the saw, so lots of dust flies everywhere. See, I've been using material that was from another project that didn't work. It's like a reuse, recycle situation. It's a keypad entry, no keys. Charging error. It resolved itself. All I had to do was just wiggle it on the base a little bit. What I was saying is the wood that I've used is recycled from another project that didn't work. And I'm not gonna spend money buying new stuff. I have to do some patching, and I'm doing that right now. And I'm fine with that. I'll do some patching, I'll sand, I may patch again if it's not right. But a lot of these will be underneath, so you won't see it. And once it's painted, it'll be even more visible. I will let this dry overnight. Tomorrow I'll prime these boards. Reality that is starting to sink in for me now is it's going to take a bunch of time to get this stuff painted so I can install the shelving unit into here. I'm going to end the video here, and in the next one you'll see me build and install the shelving unit. I appreciate you watching. You bring joy to my heart when I see those numbers on the video climb. Subscribe, click like, it helps the channel grow. And I'll see you in the next one.
Keep on doing what you do, doing what you do.